let's listen to this one. I have no idea who this. I've never even heard this song before cool. in my life.
Do you have the lyrics up there? Because yeah. I'll help. Okay. What's up, guys? Welcome back to JPMP. I'm Justin.
I'm Manny.
And today we are listening to Angels and Airwaves, the song Secret Crowds. I've heard of them.
Me too.
I don't know.
Long time ago.
Anything about them.
Yeah, I only know the one song. Well, I'm the same last dream I got.
So, singer from Blink 182?
Yeah.
Okay. Singer. Anyone else?
I don't know.
I feel like someone in here was like part of something else. That's... I don't
know. I think the bassist is...
So
I never heard the song. they're coming back like on tour and stuff like that. So okay. like I figured like I never got into them when I was younger. I don't think because I was I just don't think I was like ready for it.
I just don't know them really. So
why not?
Join us on Twitter. Let us know what you think of the song. Join us on Instagram and in the comments below. Let's get into it. Angels and Airwaves. Secret Crowds. Secret Crowds. Sorry.
Thank you. I enjoyed it more than I thought.
Yes, I would. From what my preconceptions were.
Yeah, yeah.
This felt like a very decent pop rock single.
Yeah.
Right? From like a new album or whatever. Mm-hmm. I do like his voice. I like his higher tone.
You like his voice.
I like his voice. Yeah, yeah.
You like the inflections? Most people, yeah. That would turn people off.
It's kind of like in the back of his throat, like that higher. I like it. Yeah, there's no problem with that. I like the drumming because even though it's very simple, there's nothing complicated at all going on, but it's very clean. It's just very clean, keeps the groove going, keeps the energy going. It's cool.
I think, clean and tight was what I was thinking.
And it carries the song very well.
Yeah.
Go back to the lyrics really quick. Yeah, so I like the idea.
Spread love like violence.
You knew that was my favorite line?
That was good.
I thought it was a great line.
And this is in 2007, so he was writing about a time that, like, I think it's even worse now. Mm-hmm. So
He's talking about his ideal world and what he would love it to be.
I think it's a very timeless song.
Absolutely. Message-wise. Yeah. If I had my own world, I'd fill it with wealth and desire. A glorious past to admire. I love that line. Mm-hmm. The voices of kids out walking dogs, birds, planes, cleanest cars. And it goes on. But yeah, I really like the line, from here to far lands to spread love and violence. Like, if he could build his own world, he'd spread his love and the love of the world.
Like
violence spreads now.
Yeah.
And I just like that line. I like that idea put in it.
I thought what was really interesting was, listen to the beginning. Mm-hmm.
I do like the sticks on the room. Yeah.
That's cool. Mm. And then you have like the looping.
Yes. Yes.
But then listen to that whole like high pitch, mm-hmm. but that similar sound.
The reversing sound coming in.
The reversing sound, but then the voice behind it.
Yes.
Pitch that up a little bit, mm-hmm. and it's something that you hear a lot of today.
Yes. Yes.
There's a lot of that.
The pitched up vocals.
Yeah, the pitched up vocals. Mm-hmm, like it's like very popular in, you know, pop music. Like,
yeah,
just like that was in 2007. Mm-hmm. I thought that's cool how like that was
incorporated into the song at the beginning,
and you hear that so much of today. That I just thought it was interesting.
The beginning riff from that, it reminded me a lot of Creed.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know why. It was something about the riff and the tone of it. It reminded me a lot of Creed.
I just enjoyed the flow. Of course, the chorus was nice and big.
Yeah, it went on a little bit too long for me for the kind of song that it was.
Yeah.
Because it went to almost 5 minutes. I think it was 4:50, somewhere in there.
Because it was four choruses at the end.
Yeah.
And I think that was more so of like a get indulged in it.
Right, and I can understand that.
Towards the ending of the album kind of thing. So, I mean,
Yeah, but for this kind of pop single, I think it could have been cut. Or if they're going to do something that long, I like when other elements are brought in, even if it's subtle. Just to kind of,
Or like a dropout somewhere.
Something just to keep you entertained for that long.
Yeah, I see it. So, I like it. I give it like a 3.8.
Okay.
Because like, I've been trying to get into them a little bit more.
It's not something I'd listen to. It's a little too pop rocky for me, and there's nothing that really stuck out for me. So for me and my listening purposes, I'd give it like a 2, generously. But yeah. Let us know what you guys thought of the song as well. Of course, join us in the comments. Join us on Twitter, especially. That was a horrible.
Wait, what didn't you like about it? That it just ran too long?
What I didn't like about it is that the style, the pop rock style, it doesn't do anything for me, and I wouldn't listen to it.
Okay.
There are other pop rock songs and bands that I would prefer over this. The songs.
Like
I can't.
The Jonas Brothers.
Would I listen to this over the Jonas Brothers?
No.
I'm thinking.
Wow.
I think I'd actually listen to the Jonas Brothers song over this.
Really?
Yeah.
Because it's like, Jonas Brothers is going for pop. Like, we know what we are at that point.
And there's kind of something, I kind of think of it like this also. I don't listen to pop. Okay? I listen to rock. So, pop rock, overall, it doesn't really interest me because I'd rather just listen to straight rock if I'm going that direction. At least pop is so separatist that I can listen to it on its own. Does that make a little sense?
It's kind of like a different its own genre.
Yeah, exactly.
And then the blend of genre, like, not every blend of genre is going
to
work.
Right, like jazz fusion, it's awesome usually, but some people would rather just listen to the jazz part, or the other part, whatever it's being fused with.
Okay.
People like different genres anyway.
Well, rock, you have pop rock, and then you have progressive rock.
There's no such thing as rock, because there is a division, right? There's different types of rock. You can't just say, I listen to rock. That tells me nothing, right? You could consider the guy we just did, Portugal and I, that was a rock song, but that's completely different than Angels and Airwaves, completely different from Genesis, but they're all under rock, you know? That's what I mean, like, you have to divide it. Even though I know some people are like, oh, you shouldn't make all these genres, well, that's how you determine what music you listen to and you want to pursue more of, you know? I can't say I want to listen to more rock. That literally tells you nothing. I want to listen to more progressive rock. Okay, now we can kind of start. I want to listen to more
art rock, math rock.
Exactly. Okay. See, now you kind of have
experimental rock.
Correct.
Progressive rock.
So that's I don't know what my point was, but
post hardcore.
Right. Hardcore.
Metal. Death metal.
Progressive metal.
Progressive metal.
Black metal. Post metal. You know? So that just gives you more
rock. Pop rock.
Because when you discover a band you like, let's just say here on the show or wherever, you discover a band you like, right? Mm-hmm. Cool. I like that. I like that sound. I want to hear more of that sound. You look up the genre. You know, even if iTunes or whatever says rock, that tells you nothing. You can't just look for rock. You have to look for whatever they're listed as, you know? That way you can kind of keep going.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Mm. So, did I even rate the song? Generous too. It's a generous too.
Yeah, it's just not your cup of tea.
Yeah, but I'm not opposed to it. I'm not opposed to listening to others, you know? So thank you guys so much for watching. Seriously appreciate it. Join us on Twitter. Join us on Instagram for comments, for discussion. And we'll see you next time.
Bye. Goodbye.